Namaste to all aspirants of Ayurveda. I am Dr. Mangala Gauri Rao, working as assistant professor in the Department of Swasthavrita and Yoga, Faculty of Ayurveda, Institute of Medical Sciences, Banaras Hindu University. Ayurveda is a science which gives highest emphasis for the diet and lifestyle, whether it is the prevention of diseases or management of disorders, in both cases. Further, in today's life, our entire universe is being swiped by certain set of diseases, non-communicable diseases like diabetes mellitus, cardiovascular diseases, as well as the hypertension, dyslipidemias, etc. Especially these are affected by the diet and lifestyle of an individual. In this condition, Ayurveda has a very apt answer in the form of a proper diet. It has been mentioned by Acharya Kashyapa, Nacha ahara samam kinchit bhaishajyam upalabhyate shakyate pyanna matrena naraha kartum niramaya. That is, no medicine is equivalent to the food, and only food can make a person disease free. Further, the timely intake of the food helps in kindling of the agni, which is the factor responsible for the digestion, assimilation, as well as metabolism in an individual. And the diet should be taken in the right combination in the different food groups, that may be cereals, pulses, fruits, vegetables, dairy products, even including the water part along with the non-vegetarian items. And again, a judicious combination is highly essential. Further, the diet management becomes successful only in presence of wide variety of healthy food preparations, because in the diseases like diabetes, the apathyas or the non-conducive diet list is long. Whenever a person comes for the doctor, it becomes very difficult for the prescription giving the right diet. So in this condition, always Acharya Kashyapa's quotation, wherein he tells Bhojya Vidhi Vikalpa has been entirely devoted to one particular context, that is the diet management. And especially in the Ayurvedic context, most of the times the preparations like Odana, Manda, Peya, Vilepi, Yusha, Bhakta, Supa, Kalka, etc. are the different formulations that have been mentioned in the classical textbooks. The varieties should be chosen as per the requirement. Further, the food preparations advocated should be comprises of the food that are non-nourishing, heavy, with a high hypoglycemic index. That frames the most important factor in the management of the diabetes or the madhumeha. And consumption of the diet rich in the calories as well as the junk food, bread, butter, etc., that aggravate the problems should be excluded from the diet. In Ayurveda, for the pramehi, the principle has been mentioned as thula pramehi balavani haikaha krishasthataishkaha paridurbalascha tam brahmayet tatra krishasya kayam samshodhanam dosha baladikasya. Here, the diabetic person is divided into two, that is sthula or the obvious diabetic and krisha or the emaciated diabetic. So if the person is emaciated, then we should give the strength promoting diet items, and if one is krisha or lean, then he has to be given the strengthening item. Further, whenever we treat a disease condition, in that time always it has been mentioned samprapti vighatanam eva chikitsa, and while diet planning also we have to do the samprapti vighatana. The different factors or the samprapti ghatakas that are responsible for the diabetes, if we think about the doshas, then vata, kapha dosha, hara, diet should be included. And among the dushyas, meda, mamsa, asruk, Shukra, Ambu, Vasa, Lasika, Majja, Rasa, Oja, all are impacted. And among the Malas, Mutra and Sveda, in the Agni, Jatharagni as well as Dhatvagni, and in the Ama, that is Jatharagni Mandyajanya Ama and the Dhatvagni Mandyajanya Ama. Further, in the Srotas, Medovaha, Mamsavaha, Rasa, Rakta, Majja, Ojas, Mutra, Sveda, all the Srotases have been deranged. And further, the Ati Pravritti is the type of Srotodushti. So, whenever we are having the Ahara Vidhi Vikalpa or the different dietary preparations, then the food that enhances the health should be included. Further, it should be Satmya for a individual. Satmya is that which is conducive for a particular individual, which is pleasant and acceptable to his mind. So, many a times whenever we indicate the pathya in the patients, if we indicate a thing that is not pleasant for a person's mind, then whatever the absorption and the conversion part of it will be impacted. Always man needs variety. Whenever a variety is given, then only a person can take a food. Same kind of a food cannot be taken by an individual daily. And again, whenever we plan the diet, we have to think about the different meals. Ideally, as per Ayurveda, it has been mentioned 2 meals per day, but as per today's context, the meals can be increased to 3 or 4. Again, in Acharya Sushruta's context, he tells Agnihotra Samovidhi. So, one has to take the food as the person does the havana, or with so much of concentration and with so much of rules and regulations, one has to take the food, that too twice daily. That is Sayam Pratar Manushyanam Agnihotra Samo Vidhi, that is in the morning as well as the evening time. But again, this is not 100% to be followed, because in the other context it has been mentioned that when the person feels hungry, then one has to take the food, because the kshut is one among the adharaniya vegas. If one feels hungry, then he at that time he has to take the food. Wherein Acharya Bhavaprakasha has indicated about the jirnahara lakshana, so one has to follow the features of the jirnahara before consuming the diet. Further, in the present day context, our life is very fast, so our meal planning should be suiting the present context. Generally, we do the breakfast, and sometimes in between the breakfast, then lunch, in between the lunch and the dinner, and then the dinner. Again, this differs from person to person. So, we have to always consider the individual preferences also while we practically plan the meal. Further, again, various forms of the foods, like always various classical preparations have been mentioned, whether it is Mandapeya Vilepi or Odana or soup, different kinds of the kalpanas have been mentioned. But in today's life, we can modify those things, and present day consumed items be very well with the healthy food variables. So that is one of the need of the day for the pathya prescription in the today's lifestyle. Because if whenever we give importance to the person's priorities, then only the person tends to follow the directions given by the physician. Otherwise, the person tends to neglect it and he tends to eat anything he wants. So better to stick on to his own preferences and design a pathya diet for a individual. So ideal form of food should suit the regional preferences, continental styles, individual preferences, time preferences, easy to prepare, commonly available food item, and that is suitable in the present day context. It has been mentioned न अभोजनेन कायाग्निर्दीप्यते न अतिभोजनेन यता निरिंधनो वन्हिर अल्प वाति इंधनावृतः. इट हैज बीन मेंशनड इन द कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ ग्रहणीय अधिकार चरक चिकित्सा 15th चैप्टर. हियर द डाइजेस्टिव फायर does not get kindled by either continuous fasting or by taking excessive of food, because excessive fuel also extinguishes the fire, or not supplying of the fuel also extinguishes the fire. Hence, one should take the food having good qualities after analyzing the factors like dosha, kala, as well as the seasonal changes and the time, whether it is morning or evening, because always the evening food or the night food should be lighter compared to the afternoon and the morning food. Further, whenever we speak about the preparation of food, at that time spices form the most important section in the preparation, because whenever the foods are used, cooking with the optimum quantity of the spices, they not only provide the flavor, taste, but they also bless an individual with a good health and longevity, and least amount of the expenditure also. And it has, many researchers have already proven that many of the non-communicable diseases like dyslipidemia, obesity, diabetes mellitus, neurodegenerative disorders, cardiovascular problems, pulmonary, metabolic, autoimmune, and neoplasms are, as well as the reducing of the cholesterol, blood pressure, and inhibiting the platelet aggregation, lipid peroxidation, and antioxidant properties. All these things have already proven by the different researches. And as per Ayurveda, if we consider, then Dhatvagni Mandya is responsible for the above said all diseases, including the diabetes mellitus. So the spices with the ushnaguna, katurasa, katuvipaka, kapha vatahara properties help in amapachana and srotoshodhana, resulting in prevention as well as cure of the diseases. Further, the srotoshodhana property also prevents many of the complications, especially related with the diabetes or the dyslipidemias. Then, as I was speaking previously, the diet planning involves the samprapti vighatana. So in the samprapti, first is the dosha involved, that is vata kapha dosha. So whatever the diet we plan should be vata kapha hara in property. So the diet chosen should be ruksha and guru at the same time, because we wanted to be non-nourishing, but at the same time not converted into sugar very easily. So such kinds of the properties are available with the items like yava or barley, bajra or the pearl millets, ragi or the finger millet, and along with that the various vegetables, seasonal vegetables will be helping them, especially the cereals and millets, kaphahara property and guru as well as ruksha. Thus, this will be helpful in counteracting the vata as well as the kapha, that is present main dosha in the diabetes. And if you think about the yava, it is vata kara, but it is guru. So this combination, like even diabetes or the madhumeha, if we think about it, is a vataja prameha. So vataja prameha, again vatakara property in the millet or the kshudradanya or the cereal that has been mentioned, this will be counteracted by the way we are preparing it. Because when we prepare this, we add a bit of water, which will give the moistness or the snigdhata. At the same time, we do the seasoning. Like Indian cooking is always, we do the seasoning and then we start put the water and then the ingredients and then cook it. So when we do the seasoning At that time, we use the different spices that will be having the kapahara property as well as the ushna guna. It is pacifying the vata property, and at the same time, we are using the ghee or oil. Again, that is having snigdhata. So that is balancing. Cooking is nothing but bringing about the balance between the properties that are basically inherent for a particular food item. So here, when we use it in combination, then it will be vata kafahara in property. And again, the various vegetables we are using, they also add on to the pacification of the doshas and bringing about the balance. Further, the guruscha apatarpanam dadhyat sthulanam karshanam prati, that has been again mentioned as a principle in the Charaka Sutra sthana, that is guru, heavy, cha apatarpanam, that is which is non-nourishing, dadhyat sthulanam, one who is, that has to be given in a sthula individual or who is an obese person for the reduction of the obesity. So here, whenever we give the, for example, the cereal like yava or barley or even the finger millet or the bajra, all these things, they are on the modern terminology, they are having the complex carbohydrates. Because of their complex nature, they are not immediately digested and getting transformed into the blood sugar. It takes more time for the digestion, so they are guru. And at the same time, they cannot be taken in very large quantity because they are heavy. So, less amount is consumed. At the same time, the it is not directly getting transformed into the sugar. So, they help in reducing the blood sugar level, and they are having the high hypoglycemic index. Further, the fruits and vegetables that are used, again they are having the nourishing property in one sense because they are having the rasayana property, and at the same time they are having the less amount of the calorie, or they don't supply much of the energy to the person. So because of that reason, the management of diabetes becomes the easier because they are having the antioxidant property. And again, as I told, vata kafahara, like again here the little bit of madhura rasa that is present in the fruits in the natural form helps in pacifying the vata dosha, because madhura rasa is pacifying, and here it is, as it is not supplying more of the calorie, it doesn't increase the sugar in a diabetic person. Further, always whenever we think about that, health and taste, both the things should be included whenever we are incorporating in a diet therapy in an individual. So various types of the traditional Indian foods, whether it is the kosambris that have been mentioned in the traditional South Indian cooking or even in Maharashtra that is available, so these kosambris, they can be used. Like, if you ask me what is kosambri, then it is a combination of the pulses as well as some of the vegetables. Like pulses, again, most commonly used is green gram or mudga. Along with that, the vegetables like cucumber, tomatoes, these can be put. And again soaked green gram is used, and it is not cooked again. Because of these properties, again it becomes guru in property. It is not digested very fast. Again, as it is given without cooking, the more of the nutrients are preserved, whether it is the antioxidants or vitamins, these are preserved well. So because of these reasons, this kosambris or the food diet in the wet form, they form an ideal component in the reducing the non-communicable diseases or even the metabolic syndrome. Further, again, various kinds of the vegetables can be used. As I told, it can be even the items like cucumber or tomatoes, along with that beetroots or carrots, like that variety can be used. And again, in the pulses also, it can be even the Bengal gram or other pulses can also be used. Again, some pulses can be cooked and used. Like if we are using the heavy pulses like rajma, then they can be used after cooking it. Without boiling is not very heavy, it becomes difficult for digestion. So whenever using the heavy dals, then it should be after cooking. Like again, they can be garnished with the coconut scrapings to give the taste also. And again, coconut scraping is not very harmful because it is one among the indirect oils. Like direct oils always need directly get converted into the fats, but the indirect oils spend much of the calories in the digestion process, so they are better compared to the direct oils. And again, they are inducing a very good taste and a natural flavor. So together they form a very good combination. And the other items like onions, they are again very good in case of the reducing blood sugar levels, so they can be added for the taste. And again, lemon can dressings can be given. And lemon, if we think about, then it is amla in rasa or sour in taste. And amla rasa is considered as one among the hridyas, or that which is good for the heart. So this will be beneficial because many a times the diabetics, they are prone for the heart problems also in a due course of time. So that is adds on to the food value. And again, it is a vitamin C rich, so it is a good antioxidant, and it gives a very good flavor also, because I was speaking about health as well as the taste along with the being pathya. Further, very variety of salads can be included in the diet. It may be like methi or the fenugreek is one of the very good anti-diabetic effect. So methi can be leaves can be used again in the seasons, especially in the winter when the methi is available, it can be used in the winters. Again, seasoning is very important. Addition of the onions as well as tomatoes for enhancing the taste, along with the lemon as well as salt and a bit of pepper seasoning, or even green chilies can be added only for the taste. Like as far as the better ingredient, it is pepper compared to the green chilies. Again, in the seasons where methi leaves are not available or fenugreek leaves are not available, in that time even the methi seeds can be used in the salad. So especially the methi seeds, if we think about, then we can take a bowl of methi seeds, soak it in the water overnight. In the morning it will get swollen, and again the water should be used for some other purpose or cooking or something like that, and that seed can be used in the salads again. Again, for the salad, different kinds of the vegetables, it may be the cucumber, tomato, as well as the onions, they can be added. And again, lemon seasoning and usage of a bit of grated coconut, all these things will be additional, and they will, and as well as dressing with the coriander leaves, small, finely cut coriander leaves, all these things will be helpful to bring about the taste as well as like the color. Like whatever it has been mentioned, like it should be very beautiful to look at, then our enzymes will be secreted well and our absorption will be good. So different colors always bring about the stimulation internally, and that will be helpful in getting assimilated well. So this forms the one of the most important things. So different colors, colored vegetables can be used in this particular salad. So again, this is one of the like always if we consider methi, then it is a bitter one, but when we use it in this particular form, then it is not that bitter. It is comparatively very less bitter. Once you taste it, then only it can be made out.